Hi Fashion One, my name is Marc Auclair. Welcome to my new jewelry store in the heart of Paris, just off the Place Vendôme. Maison Auclair is about jewelry that re-employs, that re-functionalize antiquities. So we take one-of-a-kind antiquities, they can be Mesopotamian, they can be 18th century or even 20th century, and from that we remount them on modern jewelry mountings. So the idea is to have one-of-a-kind pieces of jewelry full of history. Finding the antiquities is really the core of the mission. That's the difficult part. Basically, over the years, I've developed a network of antique dealers, auction houses, and collectioners all over Europe and including the United States, from whom I buy. The whole creative process is actually finding the pieces, finding the right pieces, then getting the right design. And often when I look at a piece, let's say in an antique dealer's shop in New York, I know exactly what type of jewelry I want with that. Then I bring it to one of my workshops in Paris, we discuss about it, and then we mount it, or they mount it for me. I go once a week to see the follow-up of the production, because as they're one of a kind, each time we work step by step, and actually during the work it evolves, and it doesn't necessarily end up the way it was designed, but there is lots of adaptation during the working process. Maison Auclair targets clients that are mostly Westerners. The client base here is, of course, French, Parisian. We launched the brand 4 years ago, but we are seeing today lots of American clients. We've got a very, very good American base, lots of great New Yorkers, for instance. But since, for the last year, we've been seeing some people from the Middle East and a bit, but not enough, some Asians. But mostly, this is for a clientele that has lots of things, that has culture, that knows about beautiful things, that has already lots of classic jewelry and is looking for something different, something more unique, and also something wearable. I often quote some of the pieces as travel jewelry. Shove that in your sponge bag or your travel bag and just go to your dinner in New York or your party in Paris or whatever. You look great, you look chic, but you don't need to take a special insurance just to carry this around. Of course, in any collection, you like most of the pieces you design. If you don't like a piece, you don't put it on the floor or in the window displays. But this being said, there are some pieces that you love more than others. I mean, some of the pieces here really strike my imagination, and today I'm particularly fond of them. And if I have a client that I like very much, I will definitely point that piece to them and say, listen, look, this is really, really nice. This is really worth looking at. It's a great antiquity and the design really works. This is chic. This is a good piece. I like it. The designer is saying to you, have a good look at that, because that for me is a good piece. In terms of material, I'm very, very fond of rock crystals, blue chalcedonies, but also the agates and chalcedonies in general. But I'm also very fond of gold and antique silver. So here we have lots of intaglios and cameos from the Greek and Roman period up to the 18th century. I'm a big fan of beads, stone beads. Beads are amazing. They're part of our culture. You find them in any civilizations since the prehistoric times. And today I collect them and I repurpose them on rings and bracelets, something like that, with lots of pleasure. I'm very fond of antique gold, Greek, Roman, Etruscan, even medieval gold for me is something extremely beautiful. The color, the sheen, the patina is unsurpassed. I'm starting to get more and more acquainted with the world of coins. My job is really a work in progress. There is the general culture, there is what you know, but I mean, there's so many domains in sumptuary arts or even decorative art. It's a never-ending job. I mean, I could spend my whole life in the library learning, 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 and that's what's so fun about it. It's never finished. I'm very, very careful about prices. I do think that being modern is also offering a price range that suits my clients. As I said earlier, they've got everything. They've got the big stones and the Rivieras and all of that. What they're looking for today is something easy to buy, easy to wear, but looking fabulous. So my prices here range from 1,000 euros up to 40,000 euros, and that's where it's capped. We don't usually go further than that. So it's expensive, but it's not totally undoable. The whole question there is, what does a lady or a woman from the 21st century want to wear? And I think that offering her a unique piece of jewelry that is antiquity based on a modern graphic design, that could be the answer, or at least one answer.